Not woodshed. Woods, yelled Barry Chetwynd. I said that there's something nasty in the woods. The murder of Phoebe Kingshaw was the talk of the village. And thanks mostly to Chetwynd's enthusiasm for the subject, so too was the overnight shaggy beast sighting. An anonymous courting couple had described their terrifying encounter to the lad who worked the night shift at the petrol station in Larrock. He told his sister, who worked at the sausage factory, who had then told her colleagues, and the extraordinary bush telegraph that exists among small countryside communities had done the rest. Within hours, the story had spread by word of mouth across half of Bowster Borough, the facts becoming more exaggerated and sensationalised with each retelling. Somewhere along the way, it had also somehow become enmeshed with the other big story of the day, and in his butcher's shop, Barry Chetwynd was taking every opportunity to further cement the two events together in his customers' minds. I told you the beast was real, and now it's on the rampage. They say she was torn limb from limb, poor girl. What rubbish, snapped Miss Shelmerdine, in whose classroom Chetwynd had sat as a child. She upbraided the other people in the shop. Shaggy beast, indeed. Don't listen to his foolishness. You'll only encourage him. Wonderful book, Cold Comfort Farm, continued Mr. Levensholm, oblivious to the fact that the conversation had moved on. A splendid parody of those old Loam and Lovechild novels. Don't you want there to be a monster in Black Dog Wood? Said Chetwynd, smiling. I'm quite excited by the idea. I'm not the least bit surprised. You've always been a very childish boy, said Miss Shelmerdine, leaving the shop.
You can talk, said Chetwynd under his breath. You're the one who has to wear nappies these days.
Did you just say something about a monster? Asked Mr. Levensholm,